The Airbus A380 is a groundbreaking aircraft in many respects. When Airbus launched the double-decker behemoth quadjet program in 2000, it generated a massive amount of excitement for an industry that, at the time, saw no end to the need for capacity. However, it turned out to be a financial disappointment for its manufacturer. In most cases, the success of the A380 was short-lived, and its position as Airbus's flagship aircraft soon came to an end. On the other hand, the more nimble twinjet A350 is proving itself fit for the future. Despite some recent issues with a major customer, it has a strong order book and a vast array of airline operators. Let's compare these two wide bodies to see how they stand up to one another beyond their noticeable height difference. Both the A380 and A350 were created with similar mission objectives in mind and are meant to ferry large numbers of people vast distances across the globe. However, the A380 took this mission profile to the extreme. Its colossal capacity, however, was designed for an era that had already passed by the time it was flying, which ultimately became its downfall. Let's begin by looking at the specific stats and numbers for both of these two Airbus giants side by side. To make it a bit more of a level playing field, we'll choose the larger variant of the twinjet, the A350-1000. It should come as no surprise that the A380, with its two floors, dominates any conversation about passenger capacity. It maxes out at 853 passengers in a one-class layout. However, no airline has operated it to such capacity, although Emirates comes closest with a high-density 615-seat layout. A more common real-world configuration lands somewhere between 379 and 520. This puts it, theoretically, on somewhat more of an equal footing with the maximum amount of 440 for the A350-1000. However, Airbus states that it quote-unquote comfortably accommodates 350 to 410 passengers in a three-class configuration. Out of the airlines that have operated both, British Airways put 331 seats on its A350-1000 and 469 on its A380s. Despite the relationship having gone sour over the past year, the largest A350-1000 operator, Qatar Airways, operates with 327 and 517, respectively. Surprisingly, for all its size, the A380 can't go as far as the A350. The A350-1000 can travel more than 1,000 kilometers or 540 nautical miles further than the A380. With a greater range, the A350 offers more route choices for airlines around the world. Furthermore, its lower passenger capacity actually becomes an advantage, allowing carriers to consider routes to secondary airports rather than needing to stick to hub-to-hub operations. It would be amiss when talking about flexibility not to mention the airport limitations of the A380. Its huge size and vast wingspan mean it is categorized as a Code F aircraft by the International Civil Aviation Organization, or ICAO. The FAA classifies it as a Design Group 6 aircraft. This means the number of airports that can handle it is limited to around 124 worldwide. A further 95 are classed as alternates, being airports capable of landing the A380 in times of need, but not necessarily set up with the correct jet bridges and other equipment to handle it efficiently. Airbus has always tried to insist that there are almost 400 airports that could have A380 service. Still, with the type disappearing from airline fleets, we'll unlikely see any new destinations opening up in the near future. The pandemic prompted an earlier-than-planned mass exodus of four-engine aircraft from the global fleet. Beginning in March 2020, the industry witnessed a slew of quadjet retirements, including the Boeing 747, Airbus A340, and, of course, the A380. The Super Jumbo was the first to be grounded. Apart from China Southern and Emirates, which is obviously highly dependent on the aircraft, airlines have only recently begun to bring it back out of storage. However, some, like those of Air France, will not be returning to the carrier's networks. The A350, on the other hand, remained very much in use even during the crisis. One of the most significant reasons for this is the A380's poor economics. While the aircraft makes sense when flying completely full on longer routes, the A350 knocks it out of the park when it comes to fuel burn. In an interview during the height of the crisis, the CEO of Qatar Airways, Akbar Al-Bakr, commented that, "We found that on a typical one-way flight, the Airbus A350 aircraft saved a minimum of 16 tons of CO2 per block hour compared to the Airbus A380. Analysis also found that the Airbus A380 emitted over 80% more carbon dioxide per block hour than the Airbus A350 on each of these routes. People love the A380. It's big, comfortable, and quiet. But how does the passenger experience compare with a more modern aircraft like the A350? For input on this, we turn to our friends at God Save the Points for inspiration. According to Mr. Ott, there are some significant positives for the Airbus A380. He says it is whisper quiet and that its giant size makes its airborne maneuvers very stable. These aircraft often have added extras for premium passengers, such as bars or showers, and the inbuilt anti-turbulence system makes for a smooth ride. Many passengers have praised the aircraft for its spacious yet quiet cabins. On the downside, while the A380 has lots of space to make first and business class something special, the seating can often be pretty dense back in economy. Compared to more modern aircraft like the A350 and the Boeing 787 Dreamliner, the cabin pressurization is not quite up to newer standards. This means that passengers are likely to arrive feeling a bit more frazzled than when traveling on the other new mission similar jets. For the A350 in particular, passengers can expect the best cabin pressure of any aircraft. Coupled with the intelligent mood lighting, this serves to minimize jet lag and lets you arrive at your destination feeling refreshed. The high ceiling, straight walls, and wide seats add up to offer an experience of spaciousness not provided by other aircraft. It also has 5% greater humidity than even the Dreamliner, which helps prevent dehydration. The A350 doesn't have the space to provide showers or proper bar areas. However, airlines are getting creative with their layouts. Virgin Atlantic, for example, has added The Loft, a small social space for premium passengers to share a drink or watch a movie together. Overall, though, for those traveling up in first class, the A380 is somewhat unbeatable. Where else can you have a shower so high up in the air? But for us mere mortals journeying further back in the plane, the A350 comes out as the clear winner. Even if the A380 unsurprisingly snags the first spot in terms of capacity and luxuriously spacious premium offerings, it should come as no great shock that the A350 comes out a long way ahead when it comes to aircraft orders. The A380 was always a pretty niche aircraft and only ever received orders from 14 different airlines. In total, the A380 sold 251 units. Production wrapped up last year, with Airbus delivering the final ever to Emirates in December. Altogether, the A350-900 and -1000 have sold 896 examples. This divides to 743-900s and 153-1000s. It has been bought by 38 airlines and edges up towards 45 customers overall when aircraft lessors are included. The range of airlines and routes this aircraft flies proves its versatility and excellence regarding efficiency and has solidified its place in the future global fleet. For lovers of aviation, engineering, and all things unconventional, the A380 is always going to hold a special place in their hearts. The giant super jumbo broke boundaries in terms of size, range, and technology. Unfortunately, by the time it was released, the commercial aviation landscape that prompted its creation had shifted, and it just did not command the same place for which it was intended. Although its biggest operator says it's just down to airlines not utilizing it correctly. The A350, on the other hand, may lack the glamour and wow factor of its bigger sister. Nevertheless, it is a superb aircraft with excellent fuel efficiency and enough passenger comforts to please any flyer. In an age where flexibility, agility, and efficiency are prized much higher than flying hotels with showers on board, the A350 is undeniably a much better fit for the future. For an airline, the best aircraft is certainly the A350. For everyone else, let's just hope we can get over the allure and impact of the A380 and learn to love the good things that come in smaller packages too. Which one of the two is your favourite and why? Let us know in the comments. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.